about Coach Montgomery first, of course. He's a former Duke football player, very successful, National Football League. Made a decision to get into coaching, and was fortunate enough, he worked with us here when we started at Duke. Went a while, was with the Pittsburgh Steelers for a few years. We were fortunate enough to get him back. One of the things Coach Montgomery will not do is pass out compliments that have not been earned. All of your parents just didn't hear what Coach Montgomery said. He told them, we've had good camps and done a lot of things well with this camp. This group is the first group that we had no one late. Everybody was where they were supposed to be. They followed instructions extremely well. And measurables are what someone is. We try to recruit inside out, which means we're looking at who someone is, first and foremost. So the compliment certainly came, he said you got better, which is an absolute, but he also talked about who you were, which meant a lot to me. And he does not pass out compliments. I mean that, and I mean that as a compliment to him. He is the best combination offensive coordinator, quarterback, coach in the country today. So I want y'all all to give Coach Montgomery a little bit of a those of your parents, he did ask him to applaud the coaches that worked with him. Unbelievably well organized. It was like a machine. And there was no question watching the video. We got a lot of video ourselves. We have all this film. How much better we got from one day to the next was crazy. This morning's workout really looked good on the tape. And Kevin is out here on the field, just watching you work, listening to you, listening to instruction, throwing the ball more accurately. It was just the beginning. It was just the beginning. But you have been an exceptional group. Anybody want to take a shot on the 55? Five things. Help each other. All right, who's first? Help. All right. They got it, right? That's a line. Ain't where you're supposed to be. Assignment. Effort. Execution. And finish. If you're doing those things every day in your life, whether you're sitting in the classroom, whether you're doing something socially, Coach Montgomery mentioned to him social media, which we pay a lot of attention to. We drop a lot of players before we ever start recruiting based on what's on their social media. Just drop. Because as I told you, we recruit inside out. And you can read a lot about people in that regard. So we're very smart. Just be true to who I hope you are. But that is your life. Each and every day, not just on the field, being where you're supposed to be, being knowledgeable, and a great effort. He told them, just so you understand, Perry, it's not good enough to play hard. There are a lot of people that play hard. You have to play harder. You have to be prepared to play harder. Execution means we're not talking about it. That's just getting it done, huh, guys? And remember, finishers are the ones that are the most successful in life. You're not through, and I'll tell your parents appreciate this. Ask them to clean up their room. Okay, you'll see a bunch of different definitions of finish, will you not? Not kind of our definition. So the sooner you learn that, the better off you will be. And those of you that are seniors, man, we wish you great, great years. Have fun, be leaders. Your attitude is contagious. They all carry a personal climate, and all of us do. And our climate affects a lot of other people. And so that's what's contagious about all of us. So great throwing out here, great competition. You go by Chris or Christopher? Chris? Which one's which?
Big boy helmet.
The helmet. Man. Huh? Absolutely. Make it party. Just a drop in the bucket, man.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
That's pressure. Winning on the last row. Sudden death. Sudden death. So, great job. Announcements, Kevin or Kent or anything we need to announce?
Coach, the only thing is the equipment guys will have cleats and compression shirts for sale outside right by the garage door. You'll see it as you go out. They'll be there, and then those footballs that you have, Coach.
Venable?
Yes, sir.
Put them off that bag.
I do.
When you're leaving, make sure you check your number on the bag. If you don't have the right one, bring it to me, okay? Everybody check before you leave.
Also,
G?
That's fine.
That's a drop in the bucket, isn't it? I don't see a name. Wilson, GST? Man, where are you, Eli? There you go, right there. Anything else?
Also have showers available in the Brooks building in that locker room. We'll have towels in there. Guys, make sure you leave that locker room looking great. Make sure you grab all your things.
One of the things, just like I'll give you a story, leave a place better than you found. Leave people better than you found. Just think what kind of world we live in. Leave every place you go better than we found it. Leave everyone we meet better for us meeting them than we found them. That's a great way to do that day after day after day. We end every one of our practices, certainly our camps, with just a short prayer. I don't think that would offend anyone, but if you would, just touch someone, bow your heads, please. Heavenly Father, we give you great thanks for this day. Working, the opportunity to work with these exceptional young men. We ask you to bless them as they return home, be the very best leaders they can be, contribute to their team, but mostly their teammates. We ask you to give all of our guests who came to see us safe passage home. We ask you to bless the rest of their summer, keep them safe. We thank you for the fellowship and the time that we've had together. Bless us to be the very best we can be. Glorify you in your name in all that we do. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
All right, guys, stand up. Let's break this thing.